Hey, so I know what you're thinking here. You're seeing this title and you're like, what the F is this BS? Because when you search anything about materialism on YouTube, on Google, people are always like, oh my gosh, this is so bad. It is hollow. It is delusional. It does not make you happier. It is just the extremely evil and bad thing. But here I'm going to tell you exactly how I feel materialism actually helped with bettering my life, and it also does not ruin my personal finances. So let's go on this journey together. I want you to keep an open mind and just, you know, listen to my whole thing, my whole argument, my whole video before you leave some hateful comments down in the comment section, because I guarantee you can find your, I guess, answer in my video. And if not, if you finish watching the whole thing, then you can leave some hateful comments if that is what you want to do. Hey everyone, so today this is a response video to Beat the Bushes video, How to Shun Materialism and Be Rich. So, I am going to break this down into many, many points. I will break this down in 10 points, and then I will do kind of like a counter argument to each of them. So number one, buying things make us feel a certain way, not the utility value. So what Beat the Bush is saying, buying things only make us feel a certain way. The actual utility value is not very high. So with the example that he gives over and over again, it is designer bags. So designer bags, its purpose is to hold things. So even if you get an IKEA bag or a cheaper bag, the utility value, what you use it for, it's not gonna change. It's still holding things. So he's saying that you can buy a cheaper thing and not a name brand thing, because the utility value does not change, and only that feeling is different. The feeling when you purchase or when you use a certain thing. And my counter argument is that, what if on top of feeling differently, which in itself is already a type of value, because feeling differently is valuable. On top of that, there's also value retention. So when you buy a Louis Vuitton bag and you use it for a couple years and you sell it, chances are you will probably get a majority of your money back, if not more. If you buy a cheaper IKEA bag, use it for a couple years and sell it, you will probably not even be able to sell it. And if you do, you will probably only get 5 to 10% of your money back. And so, what is more worth it? Honestly, I think Louis Vuitton bags, because even 5 to 10% back, that is a very, very, very low chance. Are you going to buy a used IKEA bag? I think not. And there's also demand and supply. Usually the demand for name brand things, name brand items, name brand bags, it is a lot higher than the no-name branded items. So when you eventually want to sell your item, it is much easier to sell an item with a name brand versus an item without a name brand, even though they might have the same utility value, but their value in the marketplace, in the secondhand marketplace, is drastically different. Number two, he is saying that using name brand things or luxury bags, it is just to impress people and it gives you the elevated status. And he is hinting at the fact that this does not actually increase your quality of life. What if I tell you that this actually increases your quality of life? I'm not going to give you like a broad, general, blanket statement example. I'm just going to give you my own example. My channel, Cherry Tongue Luxury Fashion and Money Hacks, will not be what it's like today without luxury bags, without designer items. It is what it is today because I started making videos on designer items, and honestly, I wasn't so smart to figure out that this channel is going to be what it is today with these videos, but I can tell you that the second I started making videos on designer goods, my views got boosted by a lot and my subscriber count got boosted by a lot. And on top of that, you might think, subscriber count, view count, it's so shallow. It does not necessarily translate into real life income. At least in the YouTube world, you really need a lot of views to earn a substantial amount of income. What if I tell you that I believe YouTube, having this YouTube channel, also helped me get my first job, which is in a big four accounting firm. Having this YouTube channel showed them that I have persistence and dedication. These two are very, very important qualities in any job position. Yes, having this YouTube channel did help me in real life, did improve my quality of life. And you can argue that, oh yeah, but your channel does not necessarily have to be luxury fashion.
But honestly, this is what gets people to watch me. This is what gets people intrigued. This is what people want to watch. So because there is such high demand, it only makes sense that I make videos in this field, something that I'm interested in, something that people want to watch, and something that gets me a job in real life. And number three, people treat you differently, which I totally agree. Having these designer bags, designer items, they do affect how people treat you, and in a good way, because when you go to high-end places, when you carry a luxury bag, when you carry a designer item, people do treat you differently, and I enjoy that. So I agree with you, Beat the Bush. And number four, Beat the Bush is saying that buying designer items can put a strain on your personal finances. This, I do not agree. Not if you know how to manage your bag purchases. So if you watch my other videos on how to buy and sell designer bags, you know that it is possible to flip designer bags and even make money from it. So if you know how to play the designer bag game, buying designer items do not necessarily put a strain on your personal finances. Again, it is to do things logically, think your purchases through, and do things smartly. And number five, he's saying that buying these designer things equate to useless things that lose value over time. So if you watch my other video on value retention and designer brands and bags, you will know that many of the classic designer bags do not lose value over time. They actually increase in value over time. So you can actually make money after you buy a bag, use it for a couple years, or leave it in your closet for a couple years, you can actually make money. So this counter argues his statement of how buying designer things equate to having a bunch of useless things that lose value over time. And number six, he's saying that buying things equates to a piece of your life that you trade in, because most people trade time for money. So let's say you have to work 2 months for a luxury bag. So you're essentially trading in 2 months of your life with a luxury bag. This first part I agree with, but since it is possible to flip bags and make money, you're not just trading in 2 weeks of your life with a piece of designer item. You are also trading your life back when you earn profit from your bag flipping, and you're actually getting more of your life back. And I'm not saying that this is true for every designer item. If you're interested, please check out my related videos on this topic after you watch this video. So in short, if the value of your designer items go up, then you will not be losing any piece of your life and you will be gaining more of your life back. And number seven, he's saying that if you save the money you use to buy designer bags and put it into some sort of investment, or maybe 401k or any other retirement plans, you can get potentially 10x the amount when you retire. But honestly, do all of us want to have all the money come when we retire and have nothing to spend right now? I don't think so. Yes, I do agree that you should put a portion of your money into 401k or other retirement plans, but some of us also want money in the short run. And so buying designer items, flipping designer items, it is a perfect way to make a short-term income and to still enjoy designer items and in the future flip them and make a profit. Number eight, Beat the Bush brought out the example of luxury cars and how they depreciate a lot in value the moment they get driven off from the dealership. And this I completely agree, so I'm not going to say anything, because my main point is on luxury bags, not cars. Cars do tend to depreciate in value a lot. And number nine, he's saying that buying luxury does not help you build your wealth. It is the opposite effect. But what I'm saying right here is that buying luxury, if you do it right, does help you build your wealth, and it can even increase the speed of your wealth building. And number 10, he's saying that you should invest in yourself, you should develop yourself, you should make yourself a better person, and this I completely agree. Even though I don't agree that buying designer bags actually is bad for wealth building, I do agree that you should simultaneously, at the same time, work on yourself, because buying luxury goods is just a part of life. Even if you buy luxury goods and flip bags and whatnot, you still have to work on yourself, self-development, and just make yourself become a better person. This I completely agree, and that marks the end of my video. Please let me know what are your thoughts, do you disagree, agree, things like that, in the comments. I make videos every single day, so be sure to subscribe and hit that bell button to see more videos from me. I have a lot of money hacks in my info box, be sure to check those out, and see you in my next video. Bye!